So some absolutely controversial yet some big news in regarding to the Bleach anime, and where is it going to end? What is going to be the last episode of the core 2 of the Bleach anime, which may turn a few heads, and we're really just going to discuss about it because everything that I knew about it was completely wrong until realistically that PV. But regardless of what, we're going to get into it and tell you exactly what's going to be happening towards maybe the end of core 2. So sit back, enjoy. Yeah, June's going to be a busy month for Bleach news, that's for sure. So of course on Club Outside, if you didn't know, Kubo's exclusive website, he dropped some update in regards to the Bleach anime, telling us that he was working on potentially the last episode, or in this week in specifically, he was working on a specific fight, or maybe so lyrics to a song, which is important because it's about a character's specific song. And people are going to turn their heads about this once I say it. But before I do that, I do want to say that when the PV did come out and when I was editing the last video, I did notice that there was, of course, voice actor staff listing, which, of course, is natural. However, what I didn't really take into consideration was all the Prevalorone Espadas being in the voice acting list, which means that it actually goes above and beyond my initial reaction, which was going to be the invasion of the Soul Palace. So that means Mayuri is going to be there. It's going to be Giselle and his zombies versus the Prevalorone Espada. So, of course, we're going to see Zombie Toshiro and some other characters as well. So, we clearly go past that point. And my question was, when I did find that out, or when I did come to that conclusion was, well, where would it end? Like, where would it possibly end that didn't feel rushed or natural and you could leave an episode on a cliffhanger? And it seems that we may have actually gotten that answer, and it wasn't really one to which I was expecting. Now, do I know the original fight? Yes, I know the original fight as well. And to be honest with you, I would rather just leave that for everyone to be excited about, because so far, nobody's guessed it. I'll just leave it off with that. Nobody's guessed it. So that's going to be exciting. But first and foremost, what has Kubo been cooking this week? He's been cooking on a song with Shiro Sagasu. So I'll just read off the text and we'll go forth and explain that. The dubbing of the second core is approaching its final stages and important scenes are being shown here and there. This week's main scene is that of the monk. Now, if you guys don't know who the monk is, that would be in reference to Ichibei. Now, he does specifically say it is approaching its end, so it means that it hasn't ended yet, so we probably have a little bit more, and I'll explain what I think that little bit more is. But considering that this week is more focused on the monk, well, where would Ichibei really be? We see him at the start of the arc, absolutely training Renji and Rukia, X, Y, and Z, but we don't really see Ichibei until towards the invasion of the Soul Palace, being, you know, Yuha versus Ichibei himself and, of course, the Zero Division. But this is also important because he also drops a picture, which, of course, is really cool. And if you don't know Japanese, which I assume 99.9% of you don't know Japanese, the translation of this is the song of Ichibei Hayasube, Futen Taisatsuryo, which it says lyrics by Taikubo, composed and arranged by Shiro Sagasu. So, already peak right off the bat. Anything Shiro Sagasu, already peak. And Kubo working as co-artist too? Absolutely peak. But the music sheet of the song is titled O Twilight, which is the actual proper translation and not Viz's translation of Hey There, Dusk. But regardless of what. So hopefully I don't have to say this again. Futen Taisatsuryo is, of course, if you don't know, which you probably don't, is the name of Ichibei's, not Bankai, obviously we know what his Bankai is, but it is an ability of his Bankai. And it is also the incantation of the big shrine black in ink, you'll see it on screen. It is the incantation that Ichibei uses when using that ability. So of course, it's right here, I'll throw it on screen right now, of the whole incantation, if you so wish. And Kubo's essentially, with Shiro Sagasu, made a song out of it, which is going to be really exciting. And it's probably going to send absolute chills down my spine. But without going too in-depth, because I want to get to the point of this video, is that if this is the case, and this is Ichibei's Bankai, and this is going to be Yuha versus Ichibei, and this is going to be the full fight, as we assume it to be, because this specific paneling, or this specific scenario here, is literally towards that very end of that very specific fight. And if that is the case, and there's still a little bit more dubbing to go after that, the conclusion here for me, that I'm not going to say concrete, but I'm absolutely very kind of confident in saying the series, because of course, with every Core, there needs to be a cliffhanger. There needs to be that moment that you need to come back to watch Core 3. And in Core 1, it was that moment when Ichigo finally got his two twin blades. And of course, Uryu going to side with Yuha was, I guess, the big cliffhanging, shocking moment, right, to people who are anime onlys. But in this case, what is it going to be for Core 2? And I was really scratching my head about it. And I was like, oh, okay, Yuha invading the Soul Palace would have been a great cliffhanger for people to be like, whoa, this is really cool. But no, it seems that maybe it's going to be Yuha stabbing the Soul King. I think that is going to be the cliffhanger, and what a cliffhanger it's going to be. Now, of course, the other question on people's minds are, this is really fast-paced. Well, not entirely. You have to go back and look at Core 1. Now, if you was to say Core 1 was slightly fast-paced, I would have to disagree with you, except for Episode 4, which then did, like, a flashback of, like, the first three episodes of Fazbear Blue War, but it's nor here nor there. I don't think Core 1 was that fast paced, to be honest, and I thought it flowed pretty well. Did they need to make cuts for certain scenes? That's for another discussion, of course. But for Core 2, is this going to be fast paced? Now, it may seem that way because of going from the second part of the war all the way to the Soul King seems like a lot of time, but you have to look at it from a volume perspective, which I do. The first Core of Fazbear Blue War arc only covered 7 volumes to 6 volumes of the Thousand Year Blood War, which was a lot of content. 6 to 7 volumes, that's a lot. And Core 2 only covers about 6 volumes, so it's actually less material than Core 1. And it has extra added scenes as well, as we discussed many a times as well. So it all boils down to Core 3 and Core 4 are really gonna have a lot of new content in general in regards to the amount of material that we've got left to cover, which is fantastic. I'm all for it. But when I look at Core 2 and I think of its pacing, because again, many people are gonna be like, this is gonna be way too fast paced. There is no build up anymore. Like in Core 1, we had the build up. We went from like Soul Society to Heikomondo to World of the Living. We're getting introduced to new characters left, right, and center. We're getting to that anticipation of a war kicking off. And to be honest, when we come into Core 2, it's straight off the bat. We're getting a fight after fight after fight straight off the bat. And when you look at these fights, they're very quick. There's little to no dialogue whatsoever, and it is just flashiness. And back in the day, when you read these chapters on a weekly basis, these chapters could be read within less than 5 minutes. It was that quick. Because Kubo shows and doesn't tell, so you really just appreciate the artwork. So without obviously babbling on about that way too much, when speaking to animators that have worked on Bleach in the past as well, I've come to realise as well that some of them are even saying that to animate a fight scene, you will find that you will spend like a 5-second cut, and that 5-second cut will amount to 2 pages. Sure, there's padding out that animators can do, and they do, but even with the padding out and adding a little bit of extra choreography into a fight, you find that Kubo's artwork is just so, either the panels are just so big, or there's so many fights within one panel that you find that animating these things generally for 5 seconds will probably be like 2 pages, if not a whole page in and of itself. And those add up, and I get that it would seem fast paced, but that's literally gives you the feeling that a fight is actually this quick, and that's how realistically a fight would last for. I mean, if you want your One Piece Toei animation where they take 10 years to charge up and have their auras, and no diss to One Piece, but like you can have that, and that's the weekly standard of One Piece, right? They're gonna drag out things, but in this case, they don't need to drag out things. They can tell Kubo's story and even accelerate it a little bit more. But in actuality, these fights are pretty fast paced in general, so I understand why people would think that, you know, going all the way to the Soul King, that's really fast paced. But looking at it all in retrospect, when I looked at the manga volumes, actually, maybe not so much. And again, it's less volumes than we had for Core 1. So I'm very interested to see how this is all going to pan out. And yeah, to end off with Ichibe versus Yuha. That's the thing though, because when I looked at Core 1 and I saw, you know, Yamamoto versus Yuha, and I was told that this was going to be the fight of the season, to which people still think it is, and the animators still think it was the fight of that season, of that core, so to say. I don't know what that even means anymore, because Episode 7 was great. Kenpachi versus Unohana was fantastic. You had everything but the rain. Sure, the fights weren't that fantastic, but the whole arc or flashback itself was great in and of itself as well, and it was beautiful. So, in actuality, And don't even get me started on Ichigo and Yuha's talk as well. That looked absolutely gorgeous as well. So, you know, there has been some really solid episodes, even after the anticipated episode 6, which was absolutely fantastic. And you can tell a lot of resource went into that episode. So when I'm hearing things like Kenpachi versus Gremy is the one to look out for, I'm scratching my head and thinking, is it though? What does that actually even mean? Because if we get episodes close to that, like we did in Core 1, and the animation's supposed to be apparently better according to Hiramitsu, I don't know, man. I generally think we got some banging fights coming. I am a little bit worried for Ichibei versus Yuha. I was hoping that that was going to be the focused on episode. Who knows? Maybe it's going to be equal to Kenpachi versus Gremy. I don't know. So, a lot of speculation, a lot of nervousness, a lot of anxiety, but a lot of excitement as well. And especially from hearing the original fight as well, which we don't know how long will be. It could be 10 minutes, it could be 5 minutes, it could be a minute long. We don't really know how long the original fight's going to be. That's the great thing about having a Bleach anime, is that for once, the manga readers and the anime-only watchers have no idea. And that's the fun part, is that we have an expectation or we have a hype level and a level of uncertainty that makes us drive and talk about this series. And I'm excited for it. So that's my thoughts. Tell me in the comment section down below of what you guys think about Yuha versus Ichibei. Is this the way to end it, with the Soul King getting the old shanky shanky? Like the Soul King's just appeared in London or something? I don't know. But tell me your guys' thoughts, of course, in the comments section down below. And Core 3, are we going to get Ruruka? That's going to be a madness. But are we going to get Yodowichi? I think so, right? Maybe. I'm coping a little bit. But that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this one. I've been Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.